Hello friends, welcome to Shiva Academy. This video series is mainly to address the questions or the comments that I have received from subscribers either in the comment section or in the mail. Few of the comments I would have replied in the comment section itself or over the mail. If a question needs a much detailed explanation, I would post either as a separate video, or if it is a common question and if it is useful for other subscribers and viewers, I'll be posting as part of this series. So as a continuation of that, in this video, we'll see about one interesting question typically asked at a freshers interviews. So here is a simple table like a T1 which contains one column called C1, and it contains some information like 1, 0, or it's just a binary information. So the expectation is you need to write an update statement to update all the 1s into 0s and all the 0s into 1. This is just a complement of what data is available in the table 1. Now let us see how to write the update statement. So I'm just creating the test table like a T1 with few values like 1s and 0s. So let me just query from the table. So here is the input table which contains like 1s and 0. First let us write our first update statement. So see, there are like multiple ways by which you can achieve this functionality. So I'll just show you 4 different update statements. Are like 4 different ways to achieve the same functionality. First, let us write our first update statement. So update T1 set column 1 equal to, first we'll use the decode function. So it's like a simple if else functionality, right? If it is 0, you just update it back to 1. If it is 1, you just update it back to 0. So I'm saying decode of C1, if it is 0, update 1. If it is 1, update 0. Okay, let me update it. So it's updated. Let me just query from the table. Now if you see, all the 1s are updated to 0 and all the 0s are updated to 1. Let me just roll it back so that we'll see few other ways of updation. I've rolled back. Okay, now like we have 1s and 0s. Let us write the next update statement. So update T1 set C1 equal to, now I'm going to use the case statement, case expression. Case C1. When 0, then 1. Same way, if it is like 1, then 0. End. Yeah. Just execute this update statement. You will get all the 1s will be updated with 0s and all the 0s will be updated with 1. So let me just roll back this also so that we'll see 2 more methods of updation. Fine. Let me just query back from the table. So we have the initial data. Let us write the another way of update. So I'm saying update T1 set C1 equal to. So in this case, I'm not going to use either a decode or a case. I'm just going to use a pure mathematical expression only. So I'll say C1 minus 1 into minus 1. So what we are doing here is that we are just subtracting 1 from the existing value. So if it is like a negative, I'm just multiplying by minus 1 so that it will become a positive value. Just let me execute this update statement. All the rows are updated. So select star from the table. So now all the 1s are updated to 0, 0s are updated to 1. So this is the third way. Let me just roll back this also so that we'll see the fourth, one more way of updation. So here is a much simpler way to update. You say set C1 equal to 1 minus C1. That's it. So in case if it is 1, it will be updated to 0. If it is like a 0, like 1 minus 0 will be like 1, so it will just get updated to 1. The much simpler update statement. So let me just update it back. Updated. Let me just query from the table. As you can see, all the 0s are updated to 1 and 1s are updated to 0. So just to quickly recap the 4 methods. The first method, we have actually used the decode to update the 1s and 0s. The second method, we have used the case expression. Third method is a much simpler mathematical expression only. But there is another much simpler version. You just simply use C equal to 1 minus C1. So these are the 4 methods by which you can update. In fact, there are many other methods also. If you try anything new, just post it in the comment section so that it will be useful for other subscribers and viewers as well. If you have learned something new, please like this video, subscribe and stay tuned for new feature videos, interview questions, SQL practical questions and concept video. If you want any questions to be addressed, you can post it in the comment section, or you can drop to the mail ID. So whenever you are posting a scenario-based SQLs, I would suggest you just give me some sample data and your expected data so that it is easy for me to understand and post as a new video. Thanks a lot for watching this video.